I'm Mashi Scanlon, the guy on the left.
This is Paul Cheon, also known as Haumph.
Join us on Wednesday nights at 7 p.m. Pacific for Magic TV, where we answer the burning questions posed to us by you, the audience, like Chipotle or La Vic, or where do these guys get their hair done?
And also every single week, we're going to be having a special guest from Channel Fireball, like Louis Scott Vargas, Josh Arleton, Tom Martell, and many others.
With all that and Dark Steel Humphrey, we'll see you next Wednesday.
Yo, what's Hannon, people? TWoo here from Channel Fireball, brewing some magic cards back with the zombie combo deck, which was super popular. I promised to make another video with Vengevines in them, and people indicated that they wanted to see that more than perhaps another deck. So we're back with the zombies. For those of you guys who haven't seen or don't know how the deck works, basically focused around zombie infestation, which lets you discard cards to make zombies, or Lotloth Troll, which discards cards to grow this zombie. That's horrifyingly graphic art. Like, is it chewing on a heart? It looks that way. So then we have tons of things that let us, that are good to discard, like Gravecrawler, Bloodghast, and Vengevine. We can all discard and bring them back. Stinkweed Imp, we can discard, and it can dredge 5, which uncovers a lot of stuff going on. Raven's Crime and Life from the Loam to attack the opponent's hand. Life from the Loam gives us tons of lands in hand, or land creatures to grow our zombie army. And then the real exciting draw engine is our honorary goblin Squee, or honorary zombie Squee Goblin Nabob, and Veilborn Ghoul. Veilborn Ghoul is sweet because whenever you play a swamp, you get to pick it up. But Urborg makes Fetchland swamps or Golgari Rot Farm swamps, so we end up picking these up multiple times in a turn. Life from the Loam to find it all, and just vomit tons and tons and tons of zombies on the field. This deck has really exciting hands, really aggressive, fairly interactive. Doesn't have the most options in how it interacts, but it does attack the opponent's hand and offers error blockers. So it's a sweet one, and the matches today are sweet as well. As for the sideboard, everything that I have in the board pretty much works well in the graveyard, except for Abrupt Decay and Necromancer's Stockpile. But we have Tech Edge paired with Loam to go against Control decks, Raven's Crime in that bunch. Dark Blast, not in my last video set, but very important, I think, in the board, and something I overlooked as the best graveyard retrievable small removal spell there is. We've got Ancient Grudge to blow up artifacts, Necromancer's Stockpile, mostly as a shout-out to Connolly Woods, and because I want this card to be good enough. Shambling Shell, Golgari Brownscale and Knot of the Bone for a life gain, Knot of the Bone MVP. And then Vengeful Pharaoh, which is a kind of removal. I haven't been wanting this that much, but I like the idea of it. It seems sweet, so that's basically the deck. It's fun. It's aggressive. It has vomity, zombie brain desiring hands that just overrun the opponent. And I had just as much fun playing this deck for you guys the second time around as the first time around. So there's definitely something here in terms of competitiveness and fun and lasting value. So if you're into graveyard decks, this is a list you should consider. Zombie Infestation in particular is a really fun card to play with. I like it quite a bit. So hope you feel the same way, and I will see y'all in the matches. Peace.